Votes seem to be in place for the next city council president in Baltimore. Tonight, Jack Young faces some key questions: where he has hung his hat over many years, and what will he do about a potential ethical issue that dogged Sheila Dixon? I-Team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller is live in the newsroom, and she has the latest for us. Jane?
Right. Jack Young said last night it's, quote, his turn to take over the city council presidency as Stephanie Rawlings-Blake moves to the mayor's office. We gave him a chance to try to clear the air about where he's made his home and what he plans to do about his other job.
He's going to 25-25.
Jack Young has, since 1996, represented part of East Baltimore on the Baltimore City Council. He lists a home address in the district, a row house he owns near Johns Hopkins. But for much of his council tenure, he and his wife also owned this house in Harford County, a small split level in Edgewood. By his own admission, it raised a question. Did the East Baltimore politician really live in the East Baltimore community he was elected to represent? We asked him to respond after the council meeting last night.
Did you ever live in the property?
On Saturdays, some weekends. It was like a summer place.
Tax bills over the 12 years Young and his wife owned the house were sent to the Edgewood address, not the Baltimore address. And when they bought the property in 1993, they signed an affidavit as owner-occupants, which allowed them to avoid part of the transfer tax. Authorities say such documents typically suggest a principal residence.
When you're buying property, you got lots of pieces of paper that they throw up at you. And I signed many pieces of paper. I don't read everything like you don't read everything.
So, but this particular piece of paper allows you a tax break.
But if it was my property, why shouldn't I get a tax break?
So how much time do you think you spent there
a year? I have the slightest idea. I have the slightest idea.
Young and his wife sold the Edgewood house in 2005. It apparently had become too much trouble politically.
Do you have a vacation home now?
No, I do not. I sold it for the purpose of people kept saying I did not live in the city when I did live in the city. And that's why I sold it.
So this question has kind of dogged you for...
It's dogged me my whole career. My whole career.
Young now faces another question about the other job he holds outside City Hall. In 2007, Young left his job of 33 years at Johns Hopkins and took a state job, a political appointment at the Department of Human Resources. When Sheila Dixon tried to hold both a state job and the city council president's job, the State Ethics Commission cried foul. So what's Young's plan if, as expected, he claims the council president's job next week?
My plan would be to take a leave of absence because, you know, being council president right now is just an acting position. So I will be taking a leave of absence until I decide whether I'm going to run to be city council president.
But the election for the city council president isn't until the fall of 2011. When we pressed our questions, Young seemed to change his mind, at least for a moment.
And I just want to be clear on if you become council president next week, which you're likely to become, what are you going to do with that state job?
I will leave the state job.
You're going to leave it?
Mm-hmm.
You're turning your resignation?
Mm-hmm. You just asked a trick question.
I told you
I'm going to use my time that I have, and then I will be taking a leave of absence, and that's it.
Okay, but a leave of absence is not a resignation.
I will be taking a leave of absence.
Thank you, sweetie.
Under state rules, Young is only eligible for 30 days of unpaid leave. He stuck around long enough last night to say he plans to hire four of Sheila Dixon's aides for the council president's office. They are now obviously looking for work. Live tonight in the newsroom, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.